All right. Thank you everyone for joining. If you have a question for Camilla, please raise your hand. Please state your name and your media outlet before your question. We will start with questions in English, followed by any in Italian. Let's get started with Michelle, followed by Lucas.
Thank you, Brian. Hi, Camilla.
Hi.
Congratulations for the win.
Thank you.
I just want to know how you felt inside your head when you won, because we're used to seeing players react very, lots of expression when they win a tournament like this. You were kind of very calm through this. Can you describe what went through your mind after the final point?
I really think I was very emotional inside. Of course, I'm not very the one that shows a lot of, but yeah, of course, it's just amazing. I'm very happy for what I did this week.
If I may ask a follow-up question, is there a moment this week, a match, a point, a set, where you realized that you had a chance to win this tournament?
No, I think this comes with all the work I've been doing with my father. Of course, he's my coach. And so I think it's just all the work we've been putting together through all these years. And I think one day I was sure, and he was sure, that I can come in any period, because I was playing very good, actually. I was playing a very high level already a few months ago. So I think I was just believing in myself, of course.
All right, next we'll go to Lucas, followed by Jessica.
Lucas Weiss with Blue Wire Hustle. Congratulations, Camilla, on the victory this week. I want to go back to the second set today. You broke Carolina to go up 3-1. She then immediately breaks back to go back on serve in the second set. What's going through your mind at that moment, and what adjustments did you make in order to then propel you to get that second set victory?
I just I think this is tennis, that you can go forward. I mean, I was 3-1, yes, actually, but I never thought, you know, it just can happen, especially when you're playing good and the level going up, a little bit down. I mean, it's a little bit like this, especially the condition was a little bit strange, you know, was windy, very hot, humid, so it was not easy, actually, for playing. So I think it was just amazing.
Thanks, Camilla. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Right, next up, Jessica, followed by Moussab.
Hi, Camilla. Jessica Lapinski, Le Journal de Québec. Well, first, congrats.
Thank you.
And second, where do you rank this week and this title amongst all that you have accomplished since the beginning of your career?
I think it just is what I think. It's just amazing that it came, but I think I didn't have a continuity, you know, in these years. I have many injuries, so I think this year I was more able to play and being physically well. So I think I was sure that one day could come.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next up, Musa, followed by Antonin.
From Sports Kira. Congrats, Camilla, on the big
Thank
win.
Thank you.
So a couple of years ago, you had said during Wimbledon, I think, that you don't follow much tennis when you're off the court. You don't watch much tennis. Do you think that helps you mentally on the court, because it helps you tune off from the sport, and when you're on the court, it makes you fresher?
Actually, no. It's what I was saying is that when I'm off with the court, I like to do other things. For example, my mom have a brand, Jamila, the one I'm wearing all the time, of course, and I love fashion. So this for me is that in the court and when I'm in tournament, I'm very focused. I do my physical and everything. When I go home, there is other things in life too, you know. And the beautiful thing that I think. To be a woman, that you can wear things and just choose colors and different kind of dresses. So this is even, I think, life, you know.
And Thanks, Camilla.
Thank you.
Next up, Antonin, followed by Diana.
En ambassadeur de RDS, Camilla, est-ce que tu acceptes que je te pose une question en français?
Oui, c'est parfait.
Ben d'abord, félicitations pour le titre. C'est le...
Sorry, can we, let's do questions in English first.
Okay,
and then we can, yeah, just for the transcript. So we can come back to you. Next up, Diana.
Congratulations, Camilla. You're definitely into the zone where everything's working, solid strokes, good footwork, great concentration. What or who was it exactly that changed your mindset during this week at this tournament?
No, I think anything changed, nothing. I've been working all my life with my father. He's always been with me all the time. We are working hours and hours in the court, and of course the result should come. I was, I believe it, and he believed it too. So I think this week was amazing week. Very happy to have this this gift. So that actually I dedicate to him, because I have this for him, because he dedicate many hours with me, and of course this is when you dedicate all your work, so I think one day comes beautiful things, you know.
It must be difficult for you and him not to be together, for him not to be here and watch you from Italy. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yes, no, we talk 100 times per day, even for FaceTime or calls. This is no problems. I believe the distance, it's fine. No, he's always with me, you know, always. Before the match, after the match, before practice, after practice, we was talking about tactical and everything. So, but it's fine for 1 week. That it's just, I mean, we work all day together, we travel all the time together, so I think it just, we are like an amazing team, I think. Amazing, he's amazing.
Is he going to join you for your next tournaments?
Yes, I really hope he's doing many things too, so actually, yeah, I really wait him, of course.
Next, we'll go to
Gemma. Hi, Camilla. Congratulations. I wanted to build a little bit off what Diana was asking about your dad. Have you had a chance to talk to him yet after today's match?
Yeah, of course. Before, after. He was very happy. He was amazing.
He was very happy.
Yeah, of course. We put all the work together, you know, all this year. Imagine, like 25 years working together. So I think it's just amazing. And yes, as soon we're gonna see each other, we're gonna enjoy, of course.
Big hugs.
Thank you.
I know there was one point in the match where you got a little bit frustrated and threw your racket. How did you regain your composure after that?
No, I think this is very important to let go, you know, tension, you know. It's nothing, it's just... there is many times in the match that you need to do something, maybe, you know, to put out the, you know, the a little bit the stress, you know. It's a lot of work down there, so it was very hot, it was conditioned very tough, you know, very windy, so was the sixth match in the row, every day playing, so it's not easy, actually. In tennis, it's it's like this.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right, we'll do a couple in French before we move on to Italian. Go ahead, Antonin.
Donc oui, Antonin Investor de RDS. Camilla, tu en as parlé déjà un peu en anglais, mais tu viens de remporter le titre le plus important de ta carrière à 29 ans, donc ça faisait très longtemps que tu l'attendais. Qu'est-ce que ça représente pour toi, ce trophée-là?
Bah, c'est très important. Je crois que les choses viennent à un moment donné. Ça ne doit pas forcer les choses, pas du tout. Je crois seulement que ça devait arriver parce que j'étais en train de jouer vraiment bien. Ça fait des mois déjà, donc voilà, ça, C'était incroyable.
Merci, félicitations.
Merci.
Michel, do you have questions in French? Your mic is muted.
Yes, thank you. Oui, Camilla, merci de répondre à la question française. C'est Michel Lamarche, à la presse canadienne. Je veux savoir qu'est-ce qui vous attend. Est-ce que vous allez à Cincinnati? C'est quoi la, quelle est la suite?
Oui, Cincinnati, maintenant.
Merci.
Merci.
All right, now we'll go over to questions in Italian. Please raise your hand if you have a question. Go ahead, Donnie.
Ciao Camilla,
ciao
Camilla.
Congratulazioni. Grazie.
Congratulazioni. È stata veramente una grande emozione, peccato non essere lì. E hai parlato ovviamente di tutto il lavoro che hai fatto con Sergio, che purtroppo non è lì, ma ti volevo chiedere una cosa: c'è qualcosa che voi avete fatto di diverso per riuscire a mettere insieme la sequenza di partite, a controllare gli infortuni? È stato solo un po' di fortuna che ti è mancata negli ultimi anni, oppure siete riusciti a trovare la formula giusta per riuscire fisicamente a sopportare le partite, la sequenza di partite del tour?
Ma innanzitutto il passato io ormai non voglio nemmeno parlarci, perché sono stati anni, sì, molto, che secondo me il livello già ce l'ho avuto e l'ho dimostrato più di una volta di essere a livello alto fin da piccola, perché comunque ho vinto a giocatrici altissimo livello fin da piccola, e quindi secondo me adesso quest'anno sto giocando ancora meglio, perché abbiamo fatto, come avevo già detto in Australia, avevamo fatto una preparazione con mio papà incredibile di 6 settimane. Peccato, poi mi sono fatta male all'adduttore in Australia, che però già lì stavo giocando un livello altissimo, secondo me. La continuità, stavo giocando perché mi ho lavorato tanto sull'aspetto tattico e abbiamo cambiato determinate cose, specialmente nel servizio. Il servizio per me adesso è il miglior colpo, ecco, cioè posso dirlo tranquillamente. E questa settimana mi ha aiutato tanto. Dopo Tokyo ho fatto degli allenamenti con lui, cambiando determinate cose nel servizio, poi anche altre cose logicamente sul gioco, variare, anche perché adesso il gioco lo è molto più vario che prima, quello si può vedere che rallento un pochino, a volte accelero e vado più a rete anche. Quindi secondo me abbiamo lavorato molto bene, e per quello io ho detto quando ero nella premiazione che io lo dedico a lui il trofeo, perché veramente è grazie a lui questo.
E l'ultima cosa, secondo te cambierà qualcosa nel modo in cui le altre giocatrici percepiranno Camilla Giorgi? Cioè, credi che ti vedranno in maniera diversa adesso che hai vinto questo trofeo così importante?
Beh, quello non lo so, non lo so. Quello non lo so, però cioè, nel senso, sono felice che sono anche cresciuta in classifica, perché non era per me quella la classifica che avevo, quindi sono veramente felice.
E adesso subito Cincinnati?
Sì, subito, già stasera, tra 2 ore, dolce, si parte.
Bene, e devi riaffrontare la stessa giocatrice che hai battuto ieri.
Sì.
Vuoi rifare la stessa partita?
Facciamo.
Preferisci vincere in 2 set?
Sì, se è possibile, meglio, no? Dai, vediamo.
Grazie mille ancora, congratulazioni.
Grazie, Vanni, grazie.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.